Oh, did you tell him all over the next day?
Did you push back?
I just got it out of my mouth. I've been ahead in 5 seconds. I said, you haven't been stuck in this thing?
And then 5 seconds later, the biggest Ford pickup truck you've ever seen in your life, with the latest tires, everything. It was, you could bowl with that.
Jim thought that I was.
She's got to hit it.
There's some whack job. People are very strong. Some people are very strong.
Be worth it.
Could see.
Just about.
Sir, y'all were talking about water conditioning a bit.
But now it's current. Don't you think that's, you could take your information and just.
I've got my agenda. I learned about a week after I started here that y'all put these things out there and that.
And you should always check there.
Always check there.
The meeting. You wrote the article earlier.
Yeah. He's gonna pay him back.
What's that?
He's apparently. I would like to call the special call meeting for Forsyth County Board of Commissioners Thursday, August 30th, 2012, to order at 3:01 p.m. All commissioners are present, and if we'll all stand for a quick invocation pledge, please. Your Heavenly Father, please help us to make the best decision for the people in the county, and also look down upon those who protect and serve us internationally and abroad. In that one name we pray.
Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Are there any changes or modifications to the agenda? Counselor?
No, sir.
Ma'am?
No, sir.
If there are no changes or modifications to the agenda, is there a motion to adopt the agenda? I will move that we second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye. Aye. Those opposed, like sign. There is none. That passes unanimously. And we are into items for consideration and discussion, citizen or water contracts, county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, the first item on this meeting was something I think we were going to consider taking up at the last work session, and we were trying to add it to the agenda. The thought was, let's go ahead and have a special call meeting, which is today, to talk about the city county water contracts. I think I don't need to say to the board that at the present time, we do not have a city county raw or finished water contract. We have not had one since roughly May 26th of 2012. And right now, I think I've completed the directions of the board with respect to my interaction with the city to try and get a contract or secure a contract based upon the terms. The last, delivery would have been the interim. Remember the interim IGA? That would have been the last delivery, and that has been rejected by the city. So at this point, I am looking for any additional direction from the Board of Commissioners with respect to how you want to move forward.
Does anyone have any information or need
proposals they'd like to bring forward at this time?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to recuse myself from any vote and discussion before we start any discussion in this matter.
Thank you, Commissioner. Does anybody have any comments about the water contract?
I will, if nobody else does. Does anyone else have any?
I don't at this time.
I just want to clear up some misnomers, if you will. I'd like to go through, just so the public truly understands, the days that passed from the day that this board voted on the binding agreement, which became a bullet point that went over to the city. And the reason why I feel this is necessary is because it seems the mayor has told the public, and they put it on page news, that in fact what made it fall apart was a 14-page IGA that we created. Well, in fact, it was their 14-page IGA that was created, not ours. And I'd like to go through those. I've given, I don't know, who else here with the media? Anybody else? Okay, anyway, of course, that's news, got it. It just lays out each IGA that went back and forth. Once the vote went through, there's a copy of our vote. You sure can. Anybody else? Because I know we, the Board of Commissioners, has gotten us through client privilege with our attorneys. Most all of it, if you just want the back part, it might make it easier on you guys because you already have the rest of the emails.
Yeah, that's nice to have it.
Okay, fair enough. Well, you got it in the back part.
Oh, it's here?
Yeah, it is. And anyways, it just goes basically through the first letter that was sent over by our county. And Ken, this came from Doug Dare, if you want to go through that for a moment, please.
This was, actually, this was an earlier version. I believe this was actually
in April. We don't, right, I just want to get into
IGA.
May 26th is what they said. Is this when they sent back to us?
No, I believe this is actually the April IGA that was tendered over.
All right, we're going to need to get into the May from where we started.
This one over?
Yes, that would have been sent over probably in April.
This would have been the last one before the contract terminated?
No, this would have been in April. And this, in fact, generated, I think, one back from the city. In fact, no, that's not it. That's just an attachment.
Yeah, I thought that you got them in the right order. We're trying to get them to. I think you missed the exhibits on that. Anyways, when you get into our intake, into the intake that the city has, and if you get into some of the paperwork we've got here, it pretty much goes through an entire submittal from the county as well as the city that becomes a plan for how many gallons and how big the pipe should have been allowed to be or the intake should have allowed to be. And it becomes a public trust at that point between the two municipalities sharing this intake. The intake, although constructed and permitted to the city, it still was sized and built and approved for both the municipalities to use, which leaves a portion, what you could consider a public trust, to the city to use it, and us as well. I don't know, Ken, where they got this. It seems to be a tad bit out of order, but.
No, these are all, what those are exhibits to the contract that was sent over in April. That's all that is.
Yeah, but I really want to get into the May portion, and that's where I need to get to.
There he is.
For the May 22nd. I'm just trying to show you, as you get into this stuff, and it still doesn't have the right order I wanted it, but I was looking for a bullet point.
Let me help
the
you.
Lands.
Let me help you. The agreement you were just looking at was a response to our April agreement. That was sent to the city.
This
to
is where I'd like to start then.
Okay, right? and then that led to what happened in this
This is the motion on May 22nd that led to our bullet points and went over to the city. I got the first binding set of bullet points to go over there. And there they are. They're very simple bullet points, and they're in the handouts I gave everybody else. Maybe I've got one left. And then they're laid out. And we get back a letter from the city
Amos?
I'm sorry.
That's Doug's son.
It goes with that, for the binding proposal that we sent over. And then you get the letter back from the city. Your city proposal, general terms dated May 22nd. I am pleased to inform you that the city of Cumming can agree to those terms subject to council from the city and the county putting a said agreement terms into an intergovernmental agreement ratified by both government authorities. And at that moment, any reasonable human being would expect that IGA to be somewhat in similar to the bullet points in which they are saying they accept. City draws up the intergovernmental agreement. I think we got a wrong date on that one again, don't we?
No, sir.
Is that the one we want? It goes back on 20, okay. And it is page 1 of 13, which gets into some things like expanding their service area, which was not part of the bullet points. It gets into taking the 30 years of raw water down to 15 years, which was not part of the bullet points they agreed to. And I'm not trying to bash on anybody, I'm just trying to defend what the mayor told, as if we're the ones that produced this, that made it so unreasonable to do anything with, and in fact, they produced it. And I'm not gonna read every page for you, it just gives you an idea of how out from and how far apart it was from our bullet points and why we couldn't come to an agreement. If we had just simply followed the bullet points that said they agreed to, we'd have agreed it today. It shows the service area of the city is in yellow. The rest of purple is in the county. It's approximately 2/3 for the county, approximately 1/3 for the city.
Is that different than the current? Is that current? That looks like the current service area.
Yeah. So.
So did they want to expand it, or are they just clarifying?
No, they were in their thing. They asked for expansion. Were they not, Ken?
Yeah, I think in the version they sent back, Commissioner Bell, they did want to modify the water delivery areas.
Is that?
Which.
I'm just trying to.
I don't know if
sure
that's what
right.
That does, but there were some documents that were attached.
Page 8 of 13. Is that it right there?
Yeah.
And certainly, if they want to expand their.
Well, my question is because I didn't see it, but that shows that it is as shown on Exhibit A, but Exhibit A. You want to talk about this? Is Exhibit A, I just want to make sure I'm clear, is that the current service area or is that some modified service area?
I can't tell from here with the parcels. I know I have a version of something they want to modify to that John Hurd and I have been working on. I can't tell if that's it or not.
Do it again? I mean, I'm just trying to say it doesn't look like there's a difference. It just looked like it was a clarification to me.
If you want to look at it, I can see if I can tell if there's any difference. You want to go to that page?
When it was explained to me by council, it was explained they were looking to expand it, which if they were, it would explain to me why, because they want to create their need for their additional water from the stupas and additional water service.
I'm just trying to figure out where it says it, because this doesn't say that. Exhibit A is our current water service area. If it is expanded, that's fine. I just want to make sure we know where it is.
If you get down into a Tim's office, the map is absolutely different than that.
It's right over here.
Correct, but if you look at this map, that you're wondering if they're trying to expand it by not running away again.
That's it.
But you see how the yellow cuts out at the left and expands off of what this is here.
Well, Highway 20, but maybe that's what they were trying to do is expand Highway 20.
Yeah.
Is that what it is, Ken?
I believe this is different from the current map.
Okay.
You notice this bulge right here?
And then up there,
the map
that down 20 is expanded
a
little bit.
A few changes in here. This is the version that John and I have been working with, what makes the most sense.
But certainly this was not the place to do.
Okay, no, that's good.
So I think that is,
it is
I think that is different.
Good. All right, that's fine.
And that's the way it was communicated to me, that this was a version of the service area that Tim's counterpart, the city, had been working on.
So it wasn't out of the blue, we just said no, it's going to be part of this agreement, I guess.
That's correct.
I think that's fair. I think it's reasonable.
And that is a different map.
And this increases their needs, obviously, because they have a bigger service area. And it decreases our needs, and I don't know what the full purpose of that is. But.
Well, if Tim and Mr. Hurd have been working on it, is it to decrease and increase, or is it?
It's just some general shifts. I'd say overall, probably an increase to the cities.
I just want to make sure that we're totally transparent here. I mean, Commissioner Levent's done a lot of work, but he's also insinuating that they increase their service area.
They were asking to increase the service area.
So that they could get more customers, when in reality, it's something you and John.
I assume it. Well, certainly. Why else would they want to increase their service area, Mr. Bell, if they don't look for more customers?
I don't think it was that, though. Tim said it was to balance out some things that made sense.
Some of it's cleaned up, some of it's who can serve sewer better, match water and sewer. I don't know, you know, exactly what.
Would it
why
increase
they the
code, would, it, would it increase their customer base?
I would think so.
I would think so too. It would increase area, surface area.
Let's just be fair that that was not the intent. The intent has been to clean up.
Okay.
The statement was that we sent this to them, regardless of what this is.
That's great. My point is, we didn't send this to them. We had a simple little bullet point.
I just want to make sure that we're telling
this.
The public the truth. Yeah. This is something they've been working on to balance out the system.
Well, then I won't have limit. I'll just
don't add limit.
I'll keep it on where they created a 40-page document
and sent it back.
It wasn't a simple bullet point.
This was
great.
Exactly.
Okay. So it made it. And we couldn't agree to anymore, so it takes us back to ground zero. And then, of course, Ken went back and forth with them in the whole, Ken, how many times did y'all go back and forth? Do you remember the dates?
Well, a few. This was from June 25th. This was the first delivery back to the city using their verbiage where we attempted to make it more consistent with what we believe was the intent of the bullet points.
And what are all these lines through everything?
That's where we're cutting out language.
You're cutting out all this language because you felt this much did not comply with our bullet points.
Either in the structure or where it was located in the agreement, yes. I mean, like you can see with respect to the service area, and again, that language was cut out simply because the bullet points didn't reference the service area. There's nothing magical about it. I wasn't making a call about whether they're trying to expand or increase their service area. It was just that wasn't what we had sent over. That's it.
And this is another attempt?
Upon receipt of mine on the 25th, I believe the city was able to respond back in about 3 days.
On the 28th with an additional offering of another IGA.
Right.
Do you feel this IGA was anywhere remotely close to or near or in line with this board's bullet points I sent over?
A lot of this was just going back to the original version they'd sent on June 8th. I mean, there were some changes, to be fair. There were some changes, for instance, there had been one concern we had raised with respect to how much in advance we needed to make an advance request for extra water. And I think we had wanted, a certain amount of days, and they agreed and put that in there. But a lot of the verbiage went back to the old language, including, I think that included the service area again. I think if you go back somewhere in there, it'll include the service area again.
July 11th, one more attempt.
Yeah, if you can flip through it, yes, that's right. I mean, this is delivered by us to them. I'm not sure if you can flip a little farther. At some point,
and here it is again, 15 years, the original bullet point was 30. So I don't know how hard it was to follow the bullet point. I read it over and over again. It's pretty cut and dry.
Well, the original agreement was two 15-year terms, a 15-year initial term and then a 15-year renewal at the option of the county. And that is going to be reflected in there. I think this is an effort, though, by the county. This was an effort to really streamline and narrow. The original draft, I felt, had a lot of moving parts. It was ambitious, and that might have been a good thing. I think I told you all that. But since we couldn't come to agreement on it, then the effort was to really narrow it down to make it just very, very, I think I called it streamlined.
Page 2,
that's the good name. Yeah, because I think I drafted that.
All right. They have a response to it?
I think they sent back basically a variation on the version they originally came up with. Very similar. See if this has got the service area in it.
So I don't really want to dissect these. I'm just trying to show how this went through. And I think it's important the media has a copy of this just so they understand that they're not just listening to somebody saying what took place. In fact, they have solid records to trace this. Yes, absolutely. I think I have one left. I got one. I guess we need to try to get one. I don't want to sit here spend a lot of time dissecting. I'm just trying to show all that we've been through to try to pull this together. And it's just a simple set of bullet points to follow and agree upon. They at one point did. That's all I'm getting at.
Does anybody be interested to see if anybody did think to create a chart that would show the various components that strip out all of this stuff and just say the agreement of July 26th had this, and this, and then the counter had this, and this.
I didn't
and
do
really
that.
Show the, how those different parts have changed from the bullet point list to the offer that came back to the one we sent over.
Well, we all know that. We've gotten those emails over and over again. I'm just trying to get the media something so they understand that we want the bad guys to create some crazy documents.
I don't think there's anybody that's in the bad guys started negotiation of sending contracts back and forth.
No, you don't stand up and tell everybody that the county sent a 14-page IGA that you couldn't live with when, in fact, it was them that sent it over and created it.
I don't know. I don't know which one it was referring to.
I watched the whole thing. But then they made front page news.
Well, suffice it to say that we never, after our initial bullet point thing, we never sent anything over at all until we received the 14-page document from them. Is that true?
Didn't they send the first IGA over there after the bullet point? Didn't they draft that?
That's correct. Yes. That's the one that had so much stuff that it wasn't exactly right. It wasn't in line with what they agreed they would go along with our bullet points. I really don't want to spend any more time on this. I just want to get that through, just so it understands. That's not the point I'm trying to make. I don't want to sit there and dissect every one. I gave the media the copies. They can do their own reports based off that. I'm not going to sit and hold it every hour for a read through everything. This is something that's recently came to light. This is part of... I'm going to let Tim explain what this came out of exactly. What I understand is that it's a 2030 plan that the city and the county puts together. This is one page out of the city's submittal by their engineer to the EPD.
What this is, when us and the city were both asking for permit withdrawals back in 2006 and 2007, the state was making us balance our water needs to meet the Metro District's 57 million gallons a day. And so when we were preparing our letter for the EPD, we ran across the city's water permit application. And all this does is show you in the end, we both agreed to the split of the 57. You see the 17 million gallons annual average here in the year 2030. We came to almost the same conclusions and split that left right at 40 million for us, 17 annual average for the city. But what we found in the footnotes was an acknowledgement of the amount of water that we'd never seen before that was for our 4.5 million gallons a day annual average finished water that we buy. You'll see in footnote 1 and footnote 2 the amounts that in their permit it referred to that diverting back to the county when the contract expired. And the only real purpose for this is just to show how the EPD looks, and we already knew this. They look at the demand and who has the customers, and when the customers change, they can. Now, the city can more than justify what they've got now, and they need an increase. All this will show you is that there was an amount of water included in the city's permit that they recognized in their application that in 2012 would be diverted. The top of table 1, I think, states.
Can we read it for you though?
I can't see it very good from this angle. It
says all flow rates in the million gallon day and includes 15% loss for in plant use and accounted for the system's loss. So, in other words, if you have, I guess,
that's how
if you need to create 4.5 million, you're going to need 5.1 to do it.
And the last sentence in the top under Table 8 just says, following the expiration of the existing FCBOC contract in 2012, the total withdrawal amount should be adjusted accordingly. And all that's referenced for is to show how the state, they're not going to let us go out and acquire a lot of contracts with other suppliers to beef up what we need. They're going to look at our total demand, and if we've got a contract with Fulton County, they're going to subtract that off. And that's just the way they do things. They look at it as a region. It's not saying that the city doesn't need that water plus more, just like we need ours. It just shows you how the state's currently looking at and how they looked at back in 2007 permit application increases.
What does number two mean? Right,
that's a calculation of where they took the 4.5 million gallons annual average and included the 15% loss in production to deliver 4.5. And so if you increase 4.5 by 15%, you'll get 1.75. In other words, that's the raw water withdrawal amount that is associated with a finished water 4.5.
All right, so it says 5.175 million gallons a day contractual commitment to Forsyth County expires in 2012. And what do you suppose that date was about? Because our contract was expiring
yes,
in May?
Yes, when this was all applied.
And this is a permit for the average annual maximum month and maximum day flows to be modified after that date. Does that mean they no longer have that amount? It's supposed to revert back to the county, possibly?
I think they were acknowledging that our cancellation of contract would go away. The county would receive increased withdrawal permits, and then you can see there's drop in the time frame on the annual average. It goes to 12.5 up to 15.1. It drops to 11.9. Then it goes back up till they eventually get it 17. So in their chart, they showed what their annual average water usage would be, and you know, this is just
because they wouldn't need as much once we got our plant online. Is that what they're calculating?
Well, you can see it taken out there too.
Exactly.
You can see it for South County. You can see it's taken out in the year 2015.
So they expect ours to go up there, and their needs to go down in their own report. Public trust. Ken?
These are just some case blurbs setting forth some legal propositions that basically, you know, all the public officers hold a position of public trust and are charged with stewardship over those, and I think that's some legal principles you felt strongly about and wanted to share with the folks here in attendance today.
Did you do any research on enterprise funds?
No.
What is an enterprise fund?
Enterprise fund is basically a governmental function that operates very much like a private business. It's insular, with the revenues from the fund meaning to provide self-sufficiency to the utility or to the function that it's serving.
It's a separate entity from the government. By state law, has to run as a business?
Typically, yes.
Fiduciary responsibility for directors, not the board of commissioners or the city council, but the directors of that enterprise fund are to make business decisions, because the users of the system, according to state law, are the owners of the system, right?
I'm not able to tell you that.
I can tell you that. The owners of the system are the users. It's much like an EMC, where the users of the system are the owners, have a board of directors. And I just, you know, that's something that we've not talked about a whole lot, that there's a lot of discussion about this being Forsyth County versus the city, when really it's the Forsyth County Water and Sewerage Authority versus whatever their authority name is, City of Water County Authority, which are enterprise funds that by state law have to operate in business. They have to generate sufficient revenues to be self-sufficient, prepare them for repairs and maintenance and growth in the future.
There's one twist to it.
Yeah.
This board of commissioners is voting on what we do with it, not. If you had a separate water enterprise board to handle that was separate from this, I might totally agree with you. But if you twist us up into
I would
and
suggest
it
that
the
we,
council into as well.
We have allowed them to blend in, and I think contrary to what's
correct.
Contrary to what is proper.
But we are, and it has.
It's wrong.
Whatever it is, it's blended right now. So this public trust then falls into play.
Well, for what we're doing as commissioners, yes. But the authority has to operate as a business. Both sides of the street. I'm just quoting both sides of the street.
Absolutely.
I don't think the authority is charged with making a profit.
The authority has to make a
property. We make $16 million a year off our water. We pay $5.1 for our water. I have heard over and over, there's somebody in the community that says that the city of Cumming is choking the life out of citizens of Forsyth County. Do you know that 82% or something of the users of the city water system are not city residents, they're county residents? And that the entire budget for the city's water and sewer department is $12 million. We generate $16 million and $5 million of purchases. And I'd love to have a business that generates that money.
Where does it say that's profit?
No, we don't have property.
We're still in the middle of sewer plants.
They don't have property. No,
you said it's a business. If it's a business, they're supposed to go after profit.
They are.
You just said we don't have profit.
You understand?
We make $16 million. You're going to argue semantics here.
I want to explain to people,
but I think that it's also important that everybody understands what the parameters are that we're working with. That we make $16 million a year.
Well, the point of this whole thing was we voted on the ballpoint, we sent it over.
Okay, that's fine. I'm not arguing that. I agree with that.
That's all I was showing.
Right. Now, I'm trying to do, if you don't mind, I would like to.
Please go ahead.
Thank you. You know, we spend about $5.1 million a year raw water, finished water, and treatment. Generate $21 million in revenue. We are generating an additional $16 million in profits.
Can I ask you a question? How much of that goes to service, overhead, upkeep, employees?
It's gross profit, not net profit. You know, we still have to carry the sewer system that loses money. The sewer system doesn't make money. So the entire department has to balance that. But what I'm trying to get at is we have some of the lowest water rates in Metro Atlanta. Somebody was here Tuesday and said they had their water bill in their purse. It's $14. Mine's about $18. And I don't know what we're trying to accomplish here, except go to court and spend a lot of taxpayer money on it.
So because
just saying, that's where I see it going.
And when the mayor stands up and says, I'm going to shut off all your raw water, and I'm going to charge you all
that
finished. And here's the interesting part. It uses 10 or 11 million gallons a day of prime. We used 19 to 21. His plant only produces 24.
I'm not talking
about
that.
It can't even give us
I'm
water.
I'm talking about trying to come up with a price, and we want to buy water at cost. We're already generating five times what we pay for it off of our citizens. And we're sitting here arguing over where it, on a new contract, the last one we said, we're going to save something like $50 million over the current plan. I'm trying to figure out where you guys want to be. Where do you think we need to be? Do we need to pay them to give us water?
We need to sit still for a little bit. Tim, would you like to touch on a little bit about your conversations with PD and how close you believe we are to getting increased permits?
We already had permit applications in with the changes that have happened in the court rulings since in the last couple of months. The EPD promised that they should have us a response back within 30 days on our increased water permit. We don't expect them to give us our full request. They're going to look at the whole region. They need to understand what the Atlanta region needs, but they are conscious of our situation and our ability to treat our own water, and they just said that they are working on it.
Anything in writing that says that?
No.
September 16th.
Not in writing.
Do you realize we applied for a discharge permit, a civil discharge permit, 12 years ago? When I was running for office the first time, we were this close to getting this close. My opponents.
Well, what's different? We're no closer today
than we were 4 years
what's
ago.
What's different now in the last couple months than we were
The state of Georgia used our need for water in the reason to appeal the Mangusen ruling. And they said there was a need and they couldn't do anything about it. And that's why they needed to appeal the ruling. The appeals court heard it, overturned it. U.S. Supreme Court has rejected to hear that appeal. So now the state feels like they have they've released to start issuing permits. The director has said we're top priority. Staff has called weekly since we sent the letters.
Do you have anything that shows that? They've called in response to our letters. They didn't mean anything to them. I'm sorry. I don't trust the EPD on the vote. They're not responding in writing to our letters.
I've been there with you. That's the response they promised.
I've been through that with you.
In 30, so I know.
Wasn't this permit to get water out of the Chattahoochee, though?
No, it was both. We had both in. We had a permit for the lake and the river. And
so if they approve the permit, how long will it take to build an intake to get the water out, and how long will it take to get the water from the intake, either the Chattahoochee 9 miles away,
I'm not saying we have an intake,
or the, well, he's got it in his letter here, or the intake on the linear, how long will it take to build a structure like that and get it to the
The core permit's a different. Core permit's going to take longer. The core has said that they're not going to do anything for anybody until they finish their work. So 3 years. They've said that they're not going to issue anybody any increased permits until the state of Georgia tells them who needs it. They've even talked about giving the allocation to the state of Georgia to be handed out when they issue additional permits, so you won't have to go to two places. In other words, they're going to coincide with the state's withdrawal permits. So you're looking at least 3 years to get the Corps to give any kind of storage contract. Now, the Corps did tell us a few years ago that if we could show that we participated in the construction of the city's intake, they might give us the easement so you could start constructing the intake. That was before a judge ordered them not to do anything, which has been lifted now. There's a chance. Again, it's just like the others. It's a chance. So we haven't been too successful with those, that they may let you start building an intake. It will take at least 3 years to build one. So if you had permission today, you're talking at least 3 years to build the intake. But you also could have to wait 3 years.
Could we face appeals
to get that
from the environmental groups?
They're not that aggressively appealed on the, you know, they let Gwinnett build two intakes. Gainesville just built their new intake and expanded it. City of Cumming, it's just not a big environmental issue there.
And I hear what you come from. I agree with you that an intake is years out. But if we get our increased permit from EPD to come out of the lake and can work out a reasonable deal with the city for the raw water, all I'm getting at is no need at this time to buy any finished water. Nor is there any need to buy their raw water at an increased fee. However, I do believe there's a fee that we need to pay them to use their intake this reasonable.
I don't think they need to buy any finished water. I've said that since day one. Every one of my proposals, except for one that's modified, well, had no finished water.
But I don't think we need to pay those kind of fees on it either.
What do you think they need to pay?
Have to run it. It depends on if you're going to help them pay for the intake up front or payments, or if you want to work it into the payment of the water side.
So what do you think?
I'm going to wait until we see if we get the permits, because the bottom line is this. Until you have the permits on, you don't know which direction you're fully going to go.
So if we don't have the permits. Either way, you think they should get the 11.4 or not?
Possibly not. It depends how we work it out. If we get increased permits, you know, by finished water. If we don't, then we have to buy finished water.
I don't think
we
ought to buy any finished water unless we need it to supplement our own finishing plant.
Okay.
I've said that all along. We need to buy raw water also and use our plant to its fullest, and then supplement it with finished water as needed on those big days.
Do you believe we should buy raw water from them first before we use ours?
Raw water from them? Well, I don't think that we're buying raw water from them. I think that we're getting our raw water through their intake.
Over and above our permit, if we don't get increased.
If it's the only way to increase our allocation.
Yeah, we don't have enough. Yeah, we don't have enough on our
I do think, Tim, when do they say they have your letter due by the 16th of September?
He said 30 days was what she told me, and that was last week.
Can you tell me, just help me understand? I recognize that we need to increase our permit. I've never said that we don't need to increase our permit. But how does that relate to a contract for the city pumping raw water through their intake? I mean, how does that affect it? I mean, we don't have an intake. We won't have one for 6 to 10 years. How does that letter that's coming on the 16th of September impact that at all?
It only tells you whether or not you're going to have to buy finished water.
But if we bought finished water as needed to supplement,
Right.
Now, we could produce and store ahead of time and maybe not have to, but I would not want any requirement to buy finished water, although we could buy it if needed at a reasonable price. $1.95, $2.25, something like that. So what's a reasonable price to pay for water liver, to get it through the intake? It's our water, but what's the reasonable price to get it through?
What you've been paying? Why would you change what you've been paying?
We're paying cost.
We're paying willing fee.
There's no willing fee in there. There's no additional
willing fee. I call it willing fee because it's just their cost to turn the pumps, pay the electric bills.
Well, a willing fee is an additional fee charged on top of it.
If you also, look, it depends on how much 11.4 you actually feel we owe them. We need to pay them.
Well,
and then how much interest they want.
Let's just talk about, eliminate the 11.4 right now. Mm-hmm. Just forget it's even there. Mm-hmm. What do you think is a fair number to pay to bring water through that intake?
On our permit, the same as we've been paying.
Paying cost. Mm-hmm. Okay. How do you think, the argument you had about public trust, how can they accept that offer when that would be in violation of public trust for their clients to sell product or their constituents?
If they're asking us to pay for two-thirds of the intake, to use two-thirds of water.
I said forget about that. I'm talking just to bring the water through. Forget about the 11.4. We'll address that.
But you can't, because that has a very...
Assume that we're not going to have to pay for it. We're either going to have to pay for it up front or we're going to have to add it on. Let's forget about it. We know it's got to be paid.
Okay.
Let's forget about that. Yeah. Right.
But I can't forget about your answer because your answer is loaded otherwise.
It's not loaded.
If we're going to be paying for it, we agree to pay for it one way or the other. At that moment, we are paying for it equally what they paid for it, and we should be partners in it some way, somehow, whether it's a lease or ownership. So you can't act like it's theirs anymore. They have no leases to use.
Okay. Do we treat our sewer customers the same way when they buy capacity in our sewer plants?
I think you're going a little bit overboard. It's just like when you buy gas from the gas company, you don't have that say-so as the end user.
Right. It's the same type of thing. We charge a capacity fee. To use a certain capacity, yeah. That's what I'm saying. Forget about the 11.4. What would it be if we paid the 11.4? Forget about the leasehold or ownership. We know that we have to amortize it. We need to have control of it for 30 to 50 years. I agree. trying to get to a bottom line number. What do we feel?
I think it should be the percentage of our permit from the EPD against the total gallonage available from the intake.
How does that work?
Well, say the total cost for the intake is $17,000. That's what we're giving.
$17 million.
Yeah. I'm saying $17 million. Right now, we're taking 14 million gallons a day, according to our permit.
It's about 43% of the capacity of 40, it today.
No, 43% of the capacity that's used today, we're really taking 14 1/105ths
of the overall
of the capacity. So we're only using 14 1/105ths of the capacity.
Yeah, because they claim.
So right now, according to, if you use 14 million gallon, and this is somewhat debatable within a few million gallons, but let's just say 14 for the equation. I think if I got the math right, it's 14 1/105ths times 17 million. Now, 3 years from now, 2 years from now, a month from now, somehow we get our EPD permit increased to 30 million. Now we're using 30 1/105ths of it, and you would pay the incremental part on top of that.
That's what I had worked on.
That's my opinion.
I agree. I'd suggest that it's 43% today's allocations is 43.57. The city should have 57% of the income.
No, they're not. They're
yes.
using.
The total.
No, they're not. They're using 20 1/105ths.
No, they're using 57% of the permitted amounts.
Yeah, but the intake is bigger than the permitted amount.
But what I've suggested
they overbuilt at their choice.
Exactly. So the 17 million, we pay 43%, they pay 57%. Every time we increase ounces, we have to buy part of that. Same thing, buy a share of the back.
Yeah, it's just that we don't use. If you said 47, we don't use 47% of a $17 million top end number. We use.
Well, we would have overbuilt too. I mean, you have to overbuild. We overbuild our sewer plants for future.
But we're not asking anybody to share the cost with us.
No, but if you, and I agree with you, principally, we pay for our portion today, and as we increase our use, and their percentages go down, and we balance that.
But anyway, you asked him a question, I gave you my answer.
That's the 11.4.
then do you believe that the fee that the city should recover is cost only?
Very close to it. I think we should, you know, there's good discussions we could have about, if we had, you know, some real numbers here, maintenance, and we should participate fully in what we use. We should also, in my opinion, you know, to the degree that your argument, and I have not thought about your argument much, that we're making a lot of money off of our customers or a percent, we can certainly have that discussion. I'm not in favor of anybody having to overpay for anything.
We're generating $16 million above what we're paying, and it's used to fund.
You can say making, but we're not, because
we're generating.
We're generating, but you still, by the time you pay all your employees and all your trucks and all your and all your repairs, that we still have to bond money for the new plants and the new pipe that goes from the intake up to our plant. We're saying we still have to bond the same, because we don't. It's not all proper.
Like so exactly. So if we're generating five times cost, then we still have to borrow money to grow our system. Whenever I work a deal, it's got to be fair on both sides. I don't care what anybody says about who am I representing. Both parties have to be equally unhappy as Charlie.
Guess what? We had that. They agreed to it. Then what happened?
That's an agreement that we have to work through, or a disagreement we have to work through. But I think that we could probably come up with a value. But if you're insinuating the cost is fair, why don't we sell our
Here's the interesting part. If this board does not start there, knowing how the mayor always negotiates for years, for 42 years, way somewhere, but I can't even find it, somewhere over there. If we want to be anywhere near the middle, we better at least be on our side.
But you see, we've not come off of this side. You guys haven't moved off that cost. We're still sitting here today and you're still talking about 10.3 cents.
We did. We came to a great agreement. It was a fair agreement. They accepted. Hang back with some way over there stuff and 14 page thing. Well, listen.
On the bullet
point of
view,
it should have been the bullet points they agreed to.
They did, I believe. Except for we have the discrepancy on what do we pay for the additional.
Did they try to take our 30 years of 15 and 15 down to just a 15?
They made it where both the city or the county could terminate after 15.
And that doesn't work, because that's what would happen. Then we gave
the
11.
Georgia, both parties have to have the ability to terminate.
But the 11.4 pay for the intake was only to be used for the time frame of that raw water contract. That means they could shut it down half the time and still pay the full amount.
So we could have tied the 11.4 to that. I wouldn't have had a problem with that. That would have been an easy response.
Is that what they said back to us?
Well, it didn't stop us from sending something back. That's called negotiations, back and forth, until you whittle it down. I'm just wondering. It sounds like the 11.4
since,
is hung up. Where do we go on
that? But since that bullet point went over, a lot of things have changed.
Like what?
The case in federal court was overturned.
Brian, you've been here for 8 years. How many times have you heard for this court?
Never ended, huh?
Never.
Well, look, why don't we
you've
just...
Heard, I've only heard it from one person.
No, that's not true.
Well, never heard it from me.
You can wait until at least to see if they produce the money in 30 days when they set it off. So we can at least do that.
I think we're just trying to kick the can.
I think, though, that we ought to, you know, let's just say you get the permit.
Okay.
We still have to decide how you're going to get it out of the lake or the river. And not only that, but how you're going to get it to the treatment. And, you know, there's costs involved with that. But there's time involved in that as well. And to think that you might, you know, you're going to wait 3 years for like an issue permit and then you're going to get it built 3 years after that, I think that's pretty aggressive.
It is aggressive. And in the meantime, you buy your raw water to get your permits, you work out a deal with the city to run your raw water through the pipe, you don't buy the finished water.
Okay, so what do you want?
So that's what we're trying to split down.
But if you go and propose things now before we have it, what's the point?
The permit doesn't matter, Todd. We still have
even
to
if you get the permit, you're at least by at least
there's no
6 years away.
Yeah. It doesn't matter.
Here's the
if
problem.
They gave us a permit for 100 FG, it makes no difference because we still gotta pull it to the intake.
Tim officially and technically, what is the Corps' permitted allocation to the City of Cumming right now?
Average of 10 million gallons
okay.
a day.
So they actually
the permitted, not what they're using.
No, that
that's
is
the core
number.
That's the core allocation.
10 million gallons.
Well,
of water,
now
less
I
than
should, that was what they had.
In addition to that which, what if they activate this thing that the city sent over, which says that the city anticipates giving up some of their EPD allocation, and at that point the city literally is potentially selling us water that they don't have an EPD allocation for.
Be like us selling sewer capacity, we don't have that.
No, because we're not selling it to another government.
No, we're selling it to our citizens.
I don't know of anybody who is having
And
also, I don't know what how bringing that up helps us resolve in any way.
Well, it's just
I mean, we may not be perfect, but the fact that so for some reason we're not perfect does not allow a person to take the tangent that our lack of perfection should therefore cause us to enter into a bad deal with somebody else.
I'm not saying it's a bad deal. I'm saying
well, then,
we,
and I'm not going to attempt
citizens.
To justify here our perfection or lack of perfection in the arena of the
but
sewer
we
in order to come up with an argument for or against what we should
but
or should not pay for the water.
We're working with to be perfect into our total
I would say anybody who threatens to cut off our water is far from perfect.
I don't think they've got to cut it off.
How are they going to deliver it to us? They have neither the EPD permit, the pipe capacity, or the finishing
yes.
capacity.
It's not my problem.
On the last deal that he sent over here. Okay. Well, I can say he
so
doesn't.
So do we want to continue sitting here beating our chest, or do we want to try to come up with a fair price that we can pay?
Well, I certainly don't want to come up with a price based on what we do or don't do with sewer.
Why don't you come up with a price for water, Jen? You've got to do that in 2 years.
If I had my deal, we would give them water finished because we can give them water finished cheaper than they can
okay.
give us raw water.
When you get back, we really want to go in. Tell me what you're back for the water.
That's a fact. What did we say it costs us to finish the water? 60 some cents. What are they asking us to pay for
it's
the?
80 some cents at the
I mean,
volume we're going to have.
You know, we're so far into the twilight zone here on these numbers. It's ridiculous.
Because they're moving numbers all the time.
That's right. So why don't we wait until they stop moving?
They never stop moving. The more we treat, the cheaper it gets. The less we treat, the more it costs. The less they pull, the more. It's just the way it is,
Jim.
But you've yet to say what you, I mean, even if it's a percentage of the cost, is it 20%, 50%, 8%? What do you think the city's been entitled to?
I would say as close to zero as possible.
I don't know if they could do that, because based on the public trust argument, I'm not sure they can make that.
Then they need to make that argument.
I think we made it for them.
Not that I've heard.
No, I don't think so. I'm just saying that anybody that's dealing in good faith could do that.
Anybody dealing in good faith doesn't threaten to turn off the water.
Have they turned it off?
Doesn't threaten.
Have we ever
doesn't threaten.
Well,
doesn't
we ever,
doesn't
they
threaten.
They spent $17 million, and they're the deepest intake on the lake. We've never gone without water. They paid for all that stuff, which we still haven't paid for, including the $500,000 to connect our water treatment plant. We've never gone without water.
They've never gone without money.
Well, when you guys...
Look, it is kind of interesting. It makes it very hard to deal with somebody that's willing to stand up on his office of trust and his podium and make a comment that causes public panic to an extent worrying about their water. Who does that?
I don't agree. I'm not saying I condone that behavior, but it doesn't erase the fact that we don't have a contract for water.
Correct.
The permit letter that you want to get on the 16th of September doesn't make a hill of beans about what we feel is a fair price.
How long have we been paying the cost fee for bringing raw water through season take?
The cost
that was permitted based on the needs of both of our municipalities.
Are you talking cost or permit? Well, I mean,
how long have we been paying the fee for cost for raw water?
25 years.
25 years.
But we've been buying $1.6 billion in finished water, which offsets it. We've talked about that before. It's a package.
But it never said in the agreement, the only reason why you get there is because you've done this. And once you don't do this anymore, we won't give you this anymore.
I think they've said that.
It's not in writing. And it's somewhat established. That number's been established. We've re-established it through our bullet points. They sent back a letter saying they accept that part of it. Never in what they sent back disagreed with that. So why are you arguing on their behalf that it's not enough money when they haven't said it yet?
I haven't said anything. But
they haven't said it yet. You are. Why would you argue to give them more money they haven't asked for?
I'm saying cost is not a reasonable offer.
They've accepted it all. Every offer we've even done, they've never yet said that.
Well, that's with 800,000 gallons of finished water. That's okay.
How do you know that?
Because they accepted that.
All right, look, I still think we wait to see, get the 30 days for the letter.
I think you're kicking the can down the road, so you don't have to address it.
Do you realize what May was? The can's down the road already.
I know.
Patience gets the better deal. You're supposed to get the better deal for your county. Jumping into something real fast doesn't get you what
I
you need.
I'm not saying, Commissioner, this is jumping.
What do we have, 2.5 weeks left to wait for a letter? 2-3 weeks?
Look, y'all wait till January for all I care. It doesn't matter to me. I mean, it does as a citizen, but you're going to end up in court, so it's going to happen.
All right.
That is a disservice.
You and I won't be arguing ever.
No, I won't. But I will be absolutely livid that you shirked your responsibility on making a decision.
I think that's the problem. We did our responsibility. We made a decision.
Disagreements happen all the time.
And they wouldn't sign the dotted line.
Well, I agree with you.
We did. We're supposed
to. I agree with you. But you can't hold a gun to their head and make them sign. We've got to find a way to resolve it.
All right.
And waiting on an EPD letter is not going
to
solve it.
I would like to make a motion and go to the next item unless there's a proposal. Do we need a motion and a second to go to the next item? Please, let's go to the next item on the agenda.
Commissioners, the next item on the agenda pertains to the, Tim, is this the June bill or is this the July bill?
Dated, I believe, July 2nd.
It's dated, right? It's dated July 31st, but it's for water used in June.
Yes.
Commissioners, this is for both the raw and finished water invoices that we have before the county to pay. The raw water invoice is for $29,781.25. It's a billing date of July 31st, 2012, with a due date of August 15th, 2012. I also then have our finished water bill dated August 6th, 2012. With a total due of $371,715, and that total was due August 30th of 2012. Both of these invoices have now been provided to the Water and Sewer Department, and they have quite appropriately declined to issue payment until there is some authorization for them to issue payment. Quite frankly, the Board of Commissioners and my respectful position to you is I think that's appropriate. I think that it is only fair to finance and say that there will be some sort of an agreement by the Board of Commissioners to authorize this sort of a payment of money. And so you probably are looking for my analysis on whether we need to pay it or not. We do not have an IGA at this point. I believe the binding points, bullet points are what they are. I have provided you my analysis. And I have provided that to you as an attorney providing legal advice to his client, and I would be inclined not to go over it here for a whole host of reasons, not the least of which is it may get all regurgitated in a future proceeding. But my recommendation to you is that we pay both invoices, and I have provided you lengthy legal justification for why I believe that is true. Now, let me also say that as we get further down the pike with respect to not having an agreement, there will be a time, and Mr. Perkins and I have talked about this today, where the need for finished water from the city, that there will be no need, if you will, right? We under the old agreements, which is what the City of Cumming is tendering us invoices under, we have purchased finished water in advance. The first purchases have been this finished water. I believe generally it is a true statement that during the summer months we typically need that finished water. However, as the weather gets cooler, we no longer will need that finished water, and the presentation I will make to you with respect to purchasing future finished water will be different than the presentation I'm making to you now. I also believe that to the extent that we do, that you do authorize the payment of these two invoices, I believe it needs to be made under protest. And the protest is that we do not have an agreement. We need an agreement. I'm not pushing you to what that agreement needs to say. You remember, we offered an interim agreement as a placeholder agreement until we had a long-term agreement, and that has been declined. My simple statement to you is that we need an agreement. Of some kind. In the absence of one, I believe you need to make these payments, or at least, no, you need to make this payment. under protest. I will prepare the letter with the assistance of Mr. Merritt or Mr. Dare, but if the board is inclined to do that, I do need a motion, and I have one for you if you would like to look at it. And again, you need to tell me if you want to approve it. Yes, sir.
I would like to make a motion. Use the water, we'll give it back. It is what it is. I move that we authorize Forsyth County Finance Department to immediately pay July 31st, 2012 raw water bill of $29,781.25 and the August 6th, 2012 finished water bill of $371,715.38 to the City of Cumming. By that transmittal letter to the City of Cumming state, this payment is under duress and protest due to the lack of an intergovernmental agreement, and that the county's payment of these invoices will not foreclose the county's right to change any future invoice.
For the record, that's a challenge.
I'm sorry. Maybe I should have wear my glasses.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
Special meeting.
We have a motion and we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote.
Chairman, recuse yourself from the vote at this time.
Thank you. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That carries 4-0 with Commissioner Amos recused. Thank you, Council. We have a consideration of the land acquisition contract.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, I will take this one very briefly. This pertains to a land acquisition agreement the board entered into on July 5th, pertaining to a piece of property located on Bald Ridge Marina Road that the Board of Commissioners, I believe, was inclined to use for a sheriff's administration building or some form of sheriff's office. In light of our due diligence period, we believe that we found some issues with the structure that really necessitated a reduction in the price of the facility. The seller has not been willing to reduce the price by the amount that I believe the board feels is appropriate, and therefore we have actually a mechanism under the existing contract where we can get out for convenience within 60 days of July 5th, which of course is September 3rd, I believe. So to the extent the Board of Commissioners wishes to get out of the agreement, you need to authorize that by way of a motion that I have for you, in which case we will FedEx notice to the seller this evening that will terminate the agreement and result in a return of our escrow of $20,000.
If no one else wants to make a motion,
so
I will.
So
he wants us to read that.
Yeah.
The reason I'm asking for that is there's some language in the contract.
Did you write up all my motions this morning?
I thought it was very
classic. There's some language we need to adhere to in the contract.
Big words, too.
Try to keep it simple.
Okay. I move that we terminate the acquisition contract between Forsyth County and GE Commercial Finance and Business Property Corporation, the property located at 1230 Ball Bridge Marina Road, Cumming, Georgia, because the property is not suitable for county purposes, and that notice of its termination be immediately delivered to the seller in accord with the notice requirements of the contract.
Second. We have a motion. We have a second. Second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Carried unanimously. Is there any further business to come before this board, or are we needing an executive session, Councilor?
No need for an executive, Mr. Chairman.
Is there a motion to adjourn the special called meeting?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes unanimously because there was no opposition. We are adjourned at 4:03 p.m. Thank you all very much.
Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
What's up?
Because he likes.
Everybody does just a motion.
You didn't catch the white man. Nothing happened. It was unanimous. A lot of fire. Thank you. How are you doing?
According to the mayor, because I didn't send it.
That is the idea of putting into some sort of litigation. I'll try my best to remember to ask them to go ahead.